This episode of D News is brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle.
It's not easy being green. Just ask Venus. Hello, I'm Ian O'Neill, space producer for Discovery News, and I thought I'd pop into the studio today to talk about a planet that rarely gets much press, even though it's considered Earth's evil twin. I am, of course, talking about Venus, a world that's closer to the sun than Earth is, but it has an environment that's extremely hazardous to life. Well, for life as we know it anyhow. There might be little cloud-floating aliens, who knows, but that's for a different episode. For a long time, Venus remained a tantalizing mystery for astronomers. The thick, hazy atmosphere completely obscured the surface, keeping it a well-guarded secret. But after decades of observations by telescopes on the ground, unmanned spacecraft flybys, plus a Soviet lander and balloon-borne atmospheric probe, yes, we've floated a balloon in the atmosphere of another planet. We've come to realize that Venus is a deeply fascinating place. But we won't see astronauts exploring its surface anytime soon because, you know, they'd melt. So we tend to focus more attention on Earth's red sibling, Mars. But now the European Space Agency has the Venus Express satellite in orbit around Venus, there's been a lot more interest in the clouded planet and the mysteries its atmosphere contains. And one of the most mysterious things about Venus is its green glow. On Earth, we have the aurora, also known as the northern or southern lights. When we look at it, we see predominantly green light at high altitudes, but the aurora comes in a whole range of colors. The aurora happens more frequently at times of high solar activity. So when the sun throws a coronal mass ejection, basically a vast magnetized bubble of high energy particles in the Earth's direction, our planet's global magnetic field deflects the particles and injects them into the Earth's poles. The high energy particles, mainly protons and electrons, slam into the high atmosphere, causing atmospheric gases to generate light. The green light we often see is oxygen emissions. At the same time, we'll also see a red emission. That's also oxygen atoms, only at higher altitudes. But Venus doesn't have a global magnetic field like Earth's. So for the past 40 years, astronomers have been trying to understand whether or not Venus can even have auroral activity. Using a high-resolution spectrometer attached to the 3.5-meter telescope at Apache Point Observatory in New Mexico, researchers were able to spot green emissions from the Venusian atmosphere when coronal mass ejections slammed into the planet. However, these emissions were more diffuse all over the sun-facing side of the planet, as there was no magnetosphere to concentrate the high-energy particles at the poles, like Earth. Also, there was no sign of red aurora activity at high altitudes. Now they are trying to understand what chemical reaction is causing this green glow. Is it the small quantities of molecular oxygen in the atmosphere, or is something else going on? Obviously, more research is needed. This is an exciting result as we are beginning to understand how space weather impacts planets without global magnetic fields, including Mars, all in a day's work for our space weather forecasters. Do you have any wild theories to explain why Venus produces this green glow? Let us know in the comments below and please subscribe for more D News every day of the week.
This episode of D News was brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle.